U.S. airline companies have committed to reducing carbon dioxide emissions by 50% by the year 2050. And because of this, there has become an increased demand for renewable jet fuel that can be blended with the 23 billion gallons of fossil fuel currently supplying the jet fuel market. Agricultural Research Service scientist at the National Center for Agricultural Utilization Research in Peoria, Illinois, assembled a collection of yeasts that convert agricultural waste into bio-oil, which is then converted into biodiesel or renewable jet fuel.
The aviation industry is very, very interested in transitioning to sustainable aviation fuels for environmental reasons, and yet their need is largely unmet. If we can produce oil in sugarcane or other bioenergy crops that they're working on, then we can actually generate more oil on a per acre basis than we can get from, for example, soybeans. And we can also grow some of the crops they're working on marginal farmland that won't interfere with production of row crops. And furthermore, we get this large fibrous biogas cake that we need to also find a purpose for to make it economical and to increase the environmental metrics even more. And that's where our yeasts come in. We can take the sugars that we can generate from this bagasse and use our yeast to convert them into further oil that can also be used for this purpose.
One of these yeasts was used in a pilot demonstration at a commercial development center to convert sugarcane waste, also known as bagasse, into bio-oil. The yeast produced 14 gallons of bio-oil from 1 ton of bagasse. This shows the yeasts are robust enough to produce bio-oil in a commercial, large-scale operation. Not only does this accomplishment move us toward less reliance on fossil fuels, it also provides an opportunity to convert underutilized agricultural residues into value-added green biofuels that support rural economies.